Card is a powerful website builder that allows you to create websites in minutes. But the key to getting the best out of this platform and creating websites that you're proud of is to know about the powerful features that are within Card. And in this video, we're going to look at 6 key features to help you build more powerful websites so that you can build a better experience and generate more leads and sales. Be sure to go through each one of these features. I'll leave the chapters in the description. Let's start with number 1. So here we are on the Card design builder. I've just chosen a quick template and put a picture up here and a cool card website here. I'll scroll down just to show you this. So this is what it's looking like so far. And what we're going to do is look at the different features that you should be using. And let's talk about feature 1. And we need to click this button up here to talk about it, because we're going to click this publish button in a second. And the first feature that we believe you should absolutely use is Card's custom domain option. So while Card offers free subdomains, using your own domain name, it instantly gives your website that professional and credible appearance, and it also helps you if you want to move in the future, which I'll explain in a second. But as we scroll here, it's in this section here, publish to a card.co URL. So that's what you can do for free, and we'll talk about pricing later, because this one is a premium service. But this is where you publish to your own custom domain name. Now, this is fairly easy to do once you sign up for the premium plan. In fact, Card has some really good documentation in order to get this set up. But this is so important because it's essential for branding. It makes your site look polished. It also helps with SEO. And it means that, like I said before, if you want to move your website builder to Webflow, Squarespace, something else like Wix, then all you need to do is point your domain name inside your domain name manager to that new website builder. So you can build up another website in the background while this one is still live and then point it to that one. So to get this set up, just follow the instructions here, and then you can use the documentation to get the name servers correct inside your domain name manager. So that's feature number 1. Next up is the ability to embed external content. So if I click on here and I go to video, what we can do is we can put in a video here. So this is going to embed videos onto your websites. But it's not just videos, you can use other things like social media feeds. You can do third-party widgets like chat widgets and surveys. But for YouTube, all we need to do, and I've made a video on this, is follow the advice here, where you go down here, you just need to copy and paste the YouTube URL into here, and then it's going to show the video on the page. In fact, I'm just going to grab a video and show you now. So there it is. I've just copied and pasted it in here. You can do things like autoplay, loop, playback, etc. But this is just going to show your video properly and expand to the space on your website. So at the moment, it's just showing this like technical side of it. But the video is going to pop up on the Card website once you go to the URL. And with the premium service, you can also use this embed feature and use code from any type of widget that you want to use in order to embed anything onto your Card website. Now, the next feature is a premium service. All I'm going to do here is click this and say start free trial, and I'm going to have access to it. So what I've done here is I've added a contact form, because the third feature is form integrations, which is great for signups and contact information. So forms are a vital part of any website. So most people are using websites for lead generation, people getting in contact with them, they're joining email lists, etc. So this is easy to integrate a form with Card. So you can use a simple contact form, or you can integrate signup forms here, which are going to link to all of these different email service providers. So MailChimp, MailerLite, ActiveCampaign. And what you can do is then connect this form to your email signup. So this is perfect if you want to build a landing page inside Card. And all you need to do is follow the documentation, either from MailChimp or from Card, in order to get this set up correctly. Now, you can also use the widget tool to create a Typeform form, which is a more interactive kind of form as well. So if you want to use Typeform, there is a widget for that over here. Now, the next feature is responsive design. So card is designed to be mobile responsive right out of the box. But one of its best features that I made a video on, and I'll link to it in the description below, is that you can manually change different things specifically for mobile websites. So you can have different kind of things on a mobile and different kind of things on a desktop. But for the most part, unless you're really messing with things in a big way, it's going to line up perfectly. And there's not a lot of things that you have to do, really. So you can see on your screen, as we're scrolling down, this is what it's going to look like on a mobile website, and this is what it's going to look like on a desktop. So card is really set up to make it as simple as possible to create websites that look good on desktop and also on mobile. Now, the next thing we're going to look at is SEO settings. And if we go over to publish again and go to this one here, you see down here we can add meta tags. And this is a way for you to improve your rankings if you do it correctly through SEO. And you can also link up to your Google Analytics ID to track this here. Indexing is on. That's going to be the main feature here so that search engines can find your website. But these types of things are important because without proper SEO, even the most beautiful website, including this one, will remain invisible to your target audience. Now, like I said, I made a video on this, so we'll go into more depth with that in that video. Now, the next feature we want to look at is payment integration. And if you go to widget, and we're going to go back up to here, we can have a Stripe checkout, Gumroad, and PayPal. Now, we talked about how you can use Gumroad on your card website, and I've built websites with this before, so that you can link to your product or service using Gumroad. So imagine that you're selling some kind of product. It might be a digital product. For example, it might be a Chrome extension that people have to buy, or it could be video design templates that you sell, or LUTs, those types of things. What you can do is link to this on Gumroad and integrate it directly into your card website so that you enter your product URL here. You can change the button here, and then it can do things where it pops up onto the screen and the checkout is on your website. So adding payment capabilities to your website allows you to monetize your offerings without the need to set up a complex e-commerce platform. It's perfect for freelancers or people just starting with selling products, or people who just want to keep it simple throughout their lifetime of selling products. So you can use Gumroad, you can connect with Stripe here as well, you can sell things on PayPal too. I just want to discuss pricing very quickly because some of those features are pro features. And these pro features include the custom domains that we talked about, having forms, extra widgets like Stripe, etc. So for most people, you're going to want to have that pro account. The good news is, for most people, this is very affordable at $19 a year. So that's not per month, but that's per year. So I just wanted to go through that with pricing. And I'll leave a link to our other card videos in the description. So those are the features that we recommend you start using with card. Is there anything that we missed? If so, leave a comment. And if you enjoyed this video, then please like the video. Just click the button below. Now, if you want to take your no-code skills to the next level, then go to nocode.mba to check out our premium courses, all about building websites, apps, and automations using no-code tools taught by the top no-code experts. Thanks again for watching, and we'll speak to you soon. Bye-bye for now.